Thank you very much for joining us, Stormwatch 9 Weather on the Web. Here we are moving through another week, and the cooling trend that started today, even though it was well above average, rolls on through the end of the week and the first weekend of March. Up until Wednesday evening, precipitation generally scattered and fairly light, could be in the form of a light mix, and with temperatures down near 32, a few untreated surfaces may be a little bit slick, but the key here is untreated. Anything treated with temperatures near 31 or 32 should be in good shape through Wednesday evening. Then later Wednesday night, especially well after midnight through early afternoon on Thursday, heavy snow for some, mainly north, heavy rain for southern areas, and some gusty winds will follow. So here's a look at the timeline overnight tonight. 20s and 30s from north to south. Again, untreated surfaces far to the north and west may be a little bit slippery later on, as the dry conditions now eventually give way to a scattering of mixed showers during the overnight and the morning commute on Wednesday. Couple more scattered showers in the afternoon, and then energy digging in through the southern plains will turn the corner, move right up towards us by late, and we're talking about well after midnight, Wednesday night into early afternoon on Thursday. So here's a look at that timeline. During later Wednesday night, the showers increase in intensity by 2, especially 3, 4, 5 a.m. Snow north, rain south, and the trickiest call, the Lakes region, where at this point it looks more wet than white, but just a 10 or 20 mile shift in the storm track could wrap in some bouts of heavy snow for a short time, even in central parts of the state. Along with the heavy rain and the snow to the north, strong east to southeast winds pre-dawn hours of Thursday through the morning commute of over 30 to 40 miles per hour, so we could see some power outages during that time. Storm pulls away during later Thursday. Clouds could actually break before sundown, and snow showers continue in the mountains. Speaking of the North Country, that's where the highest snow tallies will be, and there should be a dramatic cutoff from north to south with the snowfall, because south of the Lakes region, mainly heavy rain. 6 to 12 inches of wet snow, White Mountains and points north, as little as a coating to an inch or two, southern Lakes region to the extreme northern parts of the Monadnock region in places like, say, Washington. Then, very tricky call from Lake Sunapee through Plymouth and just to the north of, say, Meredith. We're likely to see some rain with some wet snow mixed in. Will likely wrap up as wet snow with 2 to as much as 4 or even 5 inches of accumulation. Again, strong winds Thursday morning. Those winds crank up out of the west Thursday evening into Friday, driving in much colder air. As a matter of fact, colder than normal for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. By the way, the first weekend of March, sunny skies and seasonably chilly Monday, and maybe a wintry mix on Tuesday.